Hello everyone, welcome to azurewala YouTube channel. This is part 15 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. We will take question number 38. We have completed up to question number 37. If you haven't gone through them, please watch from the beginning. Let's move to question number 38. You have an Azure subscription named subscription 1 that contains a resource group named RG1. In RG1, you create an internal load balancer named LB1 and a public load balancer named LB2. You need to ensure that an administrator named admin1 can manage LB1 and LB2. The solution must follow the principle of least privilege. Which role should you assign to admin1 for each task? To answer, select the appropriate options in the answer area. So we have given these two tasks. One privilege we need to add backend full to LB1. Second one, we need to add a health probe in LB2. So we will understand it on the Azure portal itself. So let's move there. Now we are in our Azure portal and we have created one resource group. Under the resource group, we have certain items. For this example, we are going to use load balancer 1 and virtual machine 1. So first option, let's see. First we'll check that if we provide the contributor on LB1, the permissions for the contributor. Second option, we'll check network contributor in LB1. Third, we'll check owner contributor on resource group 1 and owner on LB1. So which one we are able to add the backend pool on LB1. So let's quickly start. So we will go to LB1 load balancer 1 and we can see here the backend pools, and we do have full permission here, so we can press the add and we can see the we can add the item into backend pool. So that is working as we are the administrator. But we will grant permission to user and let's see. So on LB1 we will go and we will go to access control. We will go for add role assignment, look for contributor, we will find privilege administrator. In this we got the contributor here. We'll press next. We'll select the member. Our member is user1 and select. We'll review and assign. So this role is assigned. So we can see the user1 has assigned the contributor role on load balancer 1. So we'll log in as user whom we have granted the permission. And we'll go to dashboard. In dashboard we can see the load balancer as we have granted the permissions, but we'll check can we add the backend pool or not. Go to backend pool, press add, and we can see here add button is disabled, so we cannot add the backend pool by having the permission of contributor on load balancer 1. Next we will check network contributor permission on load balancer 1. For that we will go back to our admin login. So we are back in our admin account. We can see that we have user 1 granted contributor. We will quickly remove this permission. And add new role, which is network contributor. This one. Next, select the user, user 1. Next, review and assign. Role assigned. So now we will be testing on network contributor. We'll go back to the user portal again. We are back to user account in portal, and we can see only one thing, that is also gone. So having the network contributor on load balancer 1, now that is back. So I'll click on that. Now I'll check if backend pool can be assigned. No, still the button is disabled here. That means having network contributor on load balancer 1 is not sufficient permission to assign the aid backend pool permission. We are back in admin portal or with the admin. So we'll remove this permission. I will check for third option. In fact, it is fourth option, but we'll check that first. So we'll assign the role. We'll go for owner permission on load balancer. So owner permission is a privileged administrator role. Owner. Next, we'll select user. User is selected, review and assign, role assigned, and we can see that now this user is user 1 is owner on load balancer 1. So let's check with the user account. We are back in user account. We'll just refresh. We got the load balancer 1, means we have the permissions now is owner. We go to backend pool, add button, and we can see that the button is disabled. The add button is disabled here, means we are not having sufficient permission in this case. Again, we'll go back to admin portal. We are in admin portal. We'll remove the permissions from here. The last option is we'll go to resource group. In the resource group, we are going to give network contributor permissions. Access control, aid, network contributor. Network contributor. Next. User, and this time we have granted the permission on resource group itself, user 1. Next, review assigned, okay, role is assigned. We'll go back to our user account. We'll simply refresh this. Refreshing entire portal. It might take time. Refresh. Now, since we are a network contributor on resource group, so we are able to view multiple items in that. So now we will go to load balancer 1, and we'll go to backend pools. We press 8. And still we are not able to see anything here. So we'll go back to the question.
And question has most of the internet, this one is correct. So I found that this is not correct. We tested it. This is also not correct. And this is also not correct. So if the permission we are providing contributor permission on load balancer, it's not working. Network contributor on load balancer one, it is also not working. Owner on load balancer one, that is also not working. But network contributor on resource group one, if we provide this permission, as per my experience on this, it is not working. But on the internet, this question is solved like that, and it is given that this answer is correct. It would be correct in case if I have two permissions, means network contributor and contributor on resource group. I'll show you right now. So we are in our admin account here, and if I give the permission, the second permission, which is contributor, and press the next with the resource and review and assign, it's adding. So now I have contributor permission and network contributor permission. Now I will go to user account and I'll go to home and refresh. And I'll go to, let's say, dashboard. Now I'll go to load balancer one. And I'll go to backend pools. Click add. After one refresh, I can see the add button is activated. And I can select the virtual machine which I want to add in backend pool. So this way only it is working. That means in most of the places the question is, maybe question has some problem or something, but it's not working with the network contributor only. It is definitely working with the contributor plus network contributor on resource group. So I have noticed this. I am not sure about this, but it is not working with only and only network contributor. I can show you again. If I remove the contributor permission, that add button in that user will get disabled. So I'll go back to user account. We'll go to dashboard. I'll hit some refresh. Again, refresh. Yes, now this refreshed. I'll go to load balancer one. I'll hit in backend pool. 8, and now you can see again it is disabled. So that proves that with the only network contributor on resource group, it is not working. However, on the internet, this is marked as correct answer. Okay, and the same way for this was for backend pool, the same way add the health probe also on load balancer 2 or load one for that matter, experiment matter load balancer 1 requires the RG1. So it's the same process, that's why I'm not repeating it. So for the exam perspective, please remember that network contributor permission is required on resource group 1 or resource group for that matter. To add the backend pool on load balancer, and to add the health probe as well require the same permission, which is the network contributor on resource group. So that's for exam, and even I have showed you the practical as well. I hope this video was informative for you, and if you like this video, please hit the like button. Also please subscribe to my channel and press the bell notification icon, and also inform your friend or share with your friends as well. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.